stage our musicians with a big round of applause.
Thank you.
Dear parents, a gentle reminder once again.
We request the audience to remain seated in this venue until the entire program is finished.
Thank you very much for your kind cooperation. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the musical extravaganza of the Arabian Nights of Hyderabad Public School, Ramanthapur 2018. Are you all ready for it? Come on, HPS, that's it? Are you all ready for it? Well, let's start the evening with a very fun music session, all right? How are you all doing tonight? A very big round of applause for the band Rhythm of Hope. Hip hip! Hip hip! Hip hip! Let's go!
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. I believe it's not too late. Together we can change the world. Lay the puzzle pieces out, find out what it's all about. Together we can change the world. Can't do it by myself, so I'm asking for your help. Together we can change the world. Sail past where it's been charted, roll your sleeves up, let's get started. Together we can change the world. Together we can change the world. With our hands and with our hearts, we can dare to make a start. Together we can change the world. What if we spoke with one voice, knowing that we have a choice? Together we can change the world. Can't do it by myself, so I'm asking for your help. Together we can change the world. Sail past where it's been charted, roll your sleeves up, let's get started. Together we can change the world. Together we can change the world. Change your mind and change your life. Set aside the fear and strife. Together we can change the world. When we open up our eyes, then we start to realize. Together we can change the world. Can't do it by myself, so I'm asking for your help. Together we can change the world. Sail past where it's been traveling, roll your sleeves up, let's get started. Together we can change the world. Can't do it by myself, so I'm asking for your help. Together we can change the world. Sail past where it's been traveling, roll your sleeves up, let's get started. Together we can change the world. Together we can change the world. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I believe it's not too late. Together we can change the world.
Are you enjoying? HPS, come on, are you enjoying? Let's move on to another very fun song. Okay. Coconut Man. Seems like everybody's got a price. I wonder how they sleep at night. When the sale comes first and the truth comes second, just stop for a minute and smile. Why is everybody so serious? Acting so damn mysterious. You got shades on your eyes and your heels so high that you can't even have a good time. Everybody look to the left. Everybody look to the right. Can you feel that? Yeah, we'll pay with love tonight. It's not about the money, money, money. We don't need your money, money, money. We just wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Ain't about the cha-ching, cha-ching. Ain't about the, yeah, ba-bling, ba-bling. Wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price that we need to take it back in time. When music made us all unite. When it wasn't no blows and video hoes. Am I the only one getting tired? Why is everybody so obsessed? Money can't buy us happiness. Can we all slow down and enjoy right now? Guaranteed we'll be feeling alright. Everybody look to the left. Everybody look to the right. Can you feel that? Yeah. We'll play with love tonight. It's not about the money, money, money. We don't need your money, money, money.
ching about it. Cha-ching, cha-ching, ching about it. Yeah, but bling, but bling, wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag.
Keep the price tag and take the cash back. Just give me 6 strings and a half stack. And you can keep the cars, limit the garage. And all it's all I need is the keys and guitars. And it's within 30 seconds I'm leaving to Mars. Yeah, we're living across this inevitable odds. It's like this, man, you can't put the price on the line. So we do this for the love, so we fight and sacrifice every night. So ain't got stem of the fall. Wait to see. We don't keep everyone moving the feet. So bring back the beat, then everyone say.
Give up a huge round of applause, the audience.
All right, HPS, are you ready for the next song?
Yeah.
You ready? Let's go.
Here's a little song I wrote. You might wanna sing it note for note. Don't worry, be happy. In every life we have some trouble, but when you worry you make it double. Don't worry, be happy. You happy now. Somebody came and took your bed. Don't worry, be happy. The landlord say your rent is late. He may have to litigate. Don't worry, be happy.
Do do do.
Ladies and gentlemen, the distinguished guests for the evening have arrived.
We are greatly honored for the pleasure of your presence with us today for this Cultural Day concert.
Seems like everybody's got a price. I wonder how to sleep at night. When the sale comes first and the truth comes second, just stop for a minute and smile. Why is everybody so serious? Acting so damn mysterious. You got shades on your eyes and your heels so high that you can't even have a good time. Everybody look to the left. Everybody look to the right. Can you feel that? Yeah, we're paying with love tonight. It's not about the money, money, money. The price tag ain't about the cha-ching, cha-ching, ain't about the ba-bling, ba-bling, wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. We need to take it back in time when music made us all unite, and it wasn't no blues and video.
Six rings and a half sack, and you can keep the calls, limit the garage, and all I need is the keys and guitars, and it's within 30 seconds I'm leaving to Mars. Yeah, we're living across this invisible art. It's like this, man, you can't put the price on the line, so we do this for the love, so we fight and sacrifice every night, so end God stumble and fall, waiting to see, this is a sign of feet. We don't keep everyone moving the feet, so bring back the beat. Then everyone say,
it's not about the money, money, money. We don't need your money, money, money. We just wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Ain't about the cha-ching, cha-ching, sing about the ba-bling, ba-bling. Wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. It's not about the money, money, money. We don't need your money, money, money. We just wanna. Forget about the price tag. Ain't about the cha-ching, cha-ching, ching about the ba-bling, ba-bling. Wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Forget about the price tag.
Take the cash back. Just give me six rings and a half stack. And you can keep the calls, limit the garage. And all I need is the keys and guitars. And it's within 30 seconds I'm leaving to Mars. Yeah, we're living across this invisible loss. It's like this, man, you can't put the price on the line. So we do this for the love, so we fight and sacrifice every night. So stumble and fall left, waiting to see. This is a sign of defeat. We don't keep everyone moving the feet. So bring back the beat, and then everyone sing.
It's not about the money, money, money. We don't need your money, money, money. We just wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Ain't about the cha-ching, cha-ching. Ain't about the bling, bling. Wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price.
Money, money, money. We just wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Ain't about the
and gentlemen, the distinguished guests for the evening have arrived.
We are greatly honored for the pleasure of your presence with us today for this Cultural Day concert. This is indeed a lovely evening.
Honorable dignitaries, ladies and gentlemen, presenting the school band once again to light up our evening, the rhythm of hope.
Extravaganza.
Thank you.
was lovely music. Surely it is the final countdown to the beginning of the Arabian Nights.
Once again, a huge round of applause for our school band, the Rhythm of Hope. They have surely set the tone and tenor for this evening to take off to great heights.
We at the Hyderabad Public School Ramanthapur feel elated to welcome Mr. Nag, Ashwin, a renowned film director, as the chief guest for the evening. A hearty welcome, sir.
We are also delighted to welcome the esteemed dignitaries, Mr. Shyam Mohan, President of the HPS Society, Mr. Gustin Oria, Vice Chairman of the Board of Governors and Vice President of the HPS Society, Mr. Faiz Khan, Secretary and Treasurer of the HPS Society, Secretary to the Board of Governors, Mrs. Radha Reddy. We deem it a special honor to also welcome to this special evening Principal of Banaska Charter High School, Poland, Mr. Bartik Pelok, Principal Hyderabad Public School, Begumpet, Mr. Skand Bali, Professor Veeramani, and our friends and students from Poland, and all other dignitaries present here. Parents, guests, and all fellow students and dear friends. Welcome to the special evening. We once again acknowledge the presence of our renowned film director, screenwriter, alumnus of HPS, Mr. Nag, Ashwin, the chief guest for the evening.
I invite sweet little Anushka to present a bouquet to our esteemed chief guest. Warm welcome, sir. Before we begin, we request our principal, Dr. Narsimha Reddy, to come onto the dais and introduce the chief guest for the evening, about whom we are eagerly waiting to know. Sir.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm delighted to welcome our chief guest of the day, Mr. Nag, Ashwin, a renowned film director, society members, board of governors of the Hyderabad Public Schools, Mr. Bartik, principal Bednarska School, Poland, students from Poland, parents, teachers, ex-teachers, other dignitaries, and my dear students. Let me take this opportunity to express my sincere thanks to all of you for coming here to witness the concert, the Arabian Nights, on this wonderful evening. I'm excited and feel proud to introduce today's chief guest, Mr. Nag, Ashwin, who was a student of the Hyderabad Public School, Begumpet, and my student as well. This young, innovative director has created a sensation in Telugu film industry by creating a legendary movie, Mahanati, in 2018. He passed out from HPS Begumpet in 2002 and graduated from Manipal Institute of Communication and New York Film Academy, USA. Nag, Ashwin began his film industry career as an assistant director for the film Nenu Meeku Telusa. He has then worked as an assistant director with Shekhar Kamula for the film's Leader in 2010 and Life is Beautiful in 2012. He worked in advertising company before joining as an assistant director in 2008. He also started a production house in 2012, which was making ads called Prana Films. A short film directed by him was selected for the Cannes Film Festival in 2013. His first feature film was Evadi Subramanyam in 2015, which has got 3 Nandi Awards, including Best Debut Director. Nagi, thank you so much for being with us today. HPS Ramanthapur has had the pleasure of producing an extraordinary musical Extravaganza around the world in 80 days in 2016. The main aim of Hyderabad Public School is to provide students with well-rounded education with a strong focus on life skills that will equip them to face the future. We at HPS Ramanthapur understand the role of performing arts in education, which not only improve the self-confidence, self-esteem of students, but also build a team spirit, thereby making them good human beings and responsible citizens. Today, once again, more than 500 students from classes 1 to 12 will celebrate and demonstrate the richness of human expression by presenting the stories of the Arabian Nights. I'm sure you will be enthralled by their performance. I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to members of HPS Society and Board of Governors for their continuous guidance and encouragement. I take immense pleasure in thanking our parents, students, teachers, support staff, and last but not least, Mr. Deepak Keshava, scriptwriter, music composer, and director, and his team who have been guiding us for past 2 months. Thank you one and all, enjoy the show, and have a great evening.
Thank you, sir. This evening seems so fascinating, so vibrant and joyous. It always lifts me up to the awe of castles and caves. I wish I could visit one for real and not just in my dreams.
Well, Sakshi, if that is how you feel, you don't have to go far to stumble into a castle or find yourself standing before a cave, because today we have lightened and festooned it all up just about that way.
Raj Rupa, do you mean all that we have read in the storybooks might really be out there in the dark and come alive tonight?
Yes, Sakshi. I'm sure this evening we'll retell the journeys we had in our history classes.
Isn't it wonderful? I cannot believe we are going to feast our souls with one today.
Aha! I promise this evening will certainly turn magical for all of us.
So here is the story of spirits.
Genies.
Large palaces.
Heaps of treasures.
Islands of rubies.
Pearls.
Velvets.
Satins.
And fragrances. Hearken to the tiding, voila! Here cometh the Arabian Nights.
Behold thou shalt timeless tales and sway to psychedelic lights.
For Alibaba's mysteries, welcome to our musical spree.
Here too the grice so earnestly, thy presence do we solicit.
And en route to childhood days again, a grand musical doth befit.
So why not brace ourselves to witness this enthralling voyage through the caves of the enchanting Arabian Nights.
Hold your breath. As we now begin.
Long time ago, Sultan Shahryar was a great king who ruled the kingdom of Persia. He had a wife whom he loved more than anything in the world, and the greatest happiness was to surround with her splendor. But after several years, he found that she has not been loyal to the Sultan. Sultan was not able to bear this. He killed his wife. From that day, he made his grand minister bring a girl to marry him that evening and kill her the next day. The whole kingdom was shocked with this attitude. The grand minister himself was the father of two daughters, of whom the elder was called Scheherazade and the younger Dinarzade. Scheherazade was highly intelligent and extremely beautiful. One day, Scheherazade asked a favor from her father that she wanted to marry Sultan Shahryar. Her father was shocked and asked her why. She said, "I am determined to stop this barbarous practice of the Sultan and to save the girls from this awful fate." Her father said, "Don't you know your fate if you marry the Sultan?" "Yes, yes, my father, I know it well, and I'm not afraid to think of it. If I fail, my death will be a glorious one. If I succeed, I shall have done a great service to my country." And from then,
thank you. Why do women comb their hair before bed?
I don't know. I never really thought about it. It's just something I do.
It's a silly thing to do. It's again going to get all messed up while you sleep.
I suppose it's one of those things one does before bed as sort of a calming ritual. Don't you have any bedtime rituals, my lord?
Huh? No, I don't have a bedtime ritual.
Some people like to read or listen to a story.
I hate stories.
Stories can relax the body and renew the mind.
Stories are a waste of time.
Stay here.
Sister! Sister!
Stop! You can't enter.
Sister!
Who'd have the audacity to shout at this later?
My lord, I'll see who it is.
Who is it?
My lord, it is my little sister, Dinarzade.
Sister, I cannot get to sleep out of worry for what might become of you tomorrow. I fear I will never be able to hear your lovely stories ever again. With the king's permission, may I hear one last story tonight?
Our king is most kind and generous. He is like the sun, which never ceases to enlighten and warm the earth, blessing it with fruitfulness. He is strong like the sun, yet gentle like the moon. Like a noble rooster, caring for his flock of hens and chicks. So our king devotes himself to attending to the needs of his little ones. Certainly, he will grant this very humble request.
Well, I suppose one story. Won't delay bedtime too much.
I want to hear a story about a genie. You said we need a genie, right?
Ah, yes. Well, I know a story about a fisherman who met a genie. But I must tell you something before we begin.
From a faraway place where the caravan camels roam, where they cut off your ear if they don't like your face. It's barbaric, but hey, it's home. When the wind's from the east and the sun's from the west and the sand in the glass is dry, come on down, stop on by, hop a carpet and fly to another Arabian night. Arabian night. Where the caravan camels roam, where they cut off your ear if they don't like your face. It's barbaric, but hey, it's home. When the wind's from the east and the sun's from the west and the sand in the glass is dry, come on down, stop on by, hop a carpet and fly to another Arabian night. Arabian night, like Arabian.
But you must promise not to laugh at me.
You know me, sister. You can trust me. I will never laugh at anything you say. Unless I'm supposed to laugh, of course.
I trust you with my life, Dinarzade. That's why I am going to tell you my secret.
What is it?
Well, don't tell anyone I said this, but I heard this story from my uncle, who heard it from his uncle, who heard it from his grandfather, who heard it from his great-grandfather, who heard it from a fisherman's wife, who lived in a small village on the coast of the Aral Sea. And she claimed the story's true.
Was she the wife of the fisherman in the story?
I don't know. All I know is that my uncle said that the fisherman's wife was as honest as a mirror, and she said the story was true.
Is this a true story then?
It's not for me to say. I just know what my uncle told me. He told me that once upon a time, there lived the Sindbad. Is a young boy who has no goal or dreams. He wasted his time and his father's wealth.
Life is good with my rich friends. Even when I'm in trouble, they're always with me.
Hey, Sindbad!
Salim!
Yes, as one wealthy friend helps another wealthy friend.
Ah, let's celebrate this moment. Let's spend this golden hour lavishly.
Ya Allah, let's celebrate.
After a few years, he loses all his money and wealth. Now he realizes he must protect his forefather's home.
What have I done? It's all my fault.
Son, be wise in the decision you take. Having fun with friends is not bad, but at what cost? Not at the cost of losing your wealth. Now, it is high time.
Sorry, Abba. I have learnt a lesson. I will abide by what you say, Abba.
Son, you're intelligent. Find a job and stand on your feet.
I promise you, Father, I'll find a job and I will make you proud.
Hey, Sindbad!
Salim!
Hello, Sindbad. Will you like to join us for the voyage to the Aral Sea?
My friend, you are a masiha to me.
A friend in need is a friend indeed. Come, let's meet the captain.
Ya Allah, bless my son.
Hurry up, lads! Time to sail! Hurry!
Aye, Captain!
My friend, here is our captain.
Ah, Salim.
Captain, he's Sindbad.
Oh boy, are you sure you want this job? To be a sailor is a very difficult job.
Yes, Captain, I need this job and I will work hard.
Let's sail, boys.
Aye, Captain.
Ah, let's sail, boys! Come on!
Ho! 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 Ho!
I've heard a lot of good things about you, Captain.
My Lord, we are the Royal Eagle Sailors, doing our duty with honesty.
You're humble and loyal indeed. I have a task for you, Captain.
Yes, my Lord.
You have to transport my wealth to my nephew's kingdom, as they are starving for food and water. I wish this wealth would help them to buy and revive their kingdom.
Sure, my Lord. We will set our course with immediate effect. Boys, get the gold sacks.
Aye, Captain.
Beware of the pirates and the monsters during your voyage.
My strength is my team, my lord. Let's sail.
Ho! 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 Ho!
Through our path. Let's loot the royal eagle ship.
Sindbad, courageous and brave man who led his sailors during the course. Meanwhile, they were passing through the lava island. They saw the beautiful sea animals and their world.
Volcano living all alone in the middle of the sea. He sat high above his bed, watching all the couples play and wishing that he had someone too. And from his lover came this song of hope that he sang out loud every day for years and years. I have a dream I hope will come true, that you're here with me and I'm here with you. I wish that the earth see the sky up above. finally meet above the sea. All together now, their lava grew and grew. No longer are they all alone with aloha as their new home. And when we visit them, this is what they sing. I have a dream I hope will come true,
that you'll grow old with me,
and I'll grow old with you. We thank the earth, steal the sky, we thank too.
Defeated!
Aye, Captain!
and courage. After defeating the monster, the royal eagle ship reaches to the village. All the villagers are happy to see Sindbad and sailors. They greet them with joy and happiness.
Sharing and caring, love and affection.
In this world, the people are selfish. They don't even bother to care for others.
Oh, my lord, it's all not true. There is one story which might change your mind.
Is it so? Then go ahead.
Sister, a magical one.
Yes, it is the story of a boy who becomes a king. The Aladdin and his three wish journey.
Shining, shimmering, splendid. Tell me, princess, now when did you last let your heart decide? I can open take you wonder by wonder, over sideways and under, on a magic carpet, why a whole new world, a new fantastic point of view. No one to tell us no, or where to go, or say we're only dreaming.
Uh-huh. Crystal clear, but now I'm in a whole new world with
now
you.
Now I'm in a whole new world with you.
Unbelievable sights, indescribable feeling, soaring, tumbling, freewheeling through an endless diamond sky. A whole new world.
Don't you dare close your eyes. Hold your breath, it gets better.
I'm like a shooting star. I've come so far. I can't go back to where I
a
used
whole new
to be.
World.
Every time you're surprised
with new horizons.
Every moment with letter.
Until the many way. This time to spare. Let me share this whole new world.
Aladdin, you saved our lives. I now announce you as a prince. You and my princess will take care of my kingdom.
Oh, Papa.
My Sultan, I wish to take the princess along with me.
Indeed, stay blessed, my children.
My princess, now we are free from the evil of Jafar.
Yes. It feels like to be free from all the trouble.
I had a dream.
Dream? What dream?
That one day I will be free and see this beautiful world with you.
This world is so beautiful, with joy and happiness, sharing and caring.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
क्या हुक्म है मेरे आका?
Oh, my friend genie, I want to make a wish.
Your wish is my command.
My first wish?
Yes, my lord.
Genie, you are my friend. And my first wish is, I want you to be free.
Your wish is my command.
Hey, yeah, I like this right here. Makes me feel free. It's got that, you know, that bomb. Ba-dum-bum, ba-da-da-da-da, mister. Ba-dum-bum, ba-da-da-da-da, world. Ba-dum-bum, ba-da-da-da-da, wide. Let's just
stay free to do whatever.
Like, bump, 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 bump,
over the world. Papa Joe Bonya Caseman with the original styling. To all the girls out there, move that body. Make them scream and shout.
My friend.
Ha, yes, Genie. Freedom means lot to us. Freedom is a great responsibility.
Responsibility?
Yes, we have freedom. That does not mean we can do whatever we want. We should understand its importance and we should believe that we can do something good.
Yes, something good.
Your second wish, my friend.
My second wish?
Aladdin? Second wish? I wish to see the future. Will the world be same, filled with love and affection, sharing and caring?
I'm curious about it. Yes, my second wish to see the future of this world.
I can take you to the future, but we can't stay there. This is against my rule.
Okay, all right then.
Your wish is my command.
Where are we? I can't see anything.
Patience, patience, my princess.
Why it's so dry and warm? I feel out of air. Where are the trees? What are these structures? Where are the humans? And what are these creatures?
These are robots.
Robots?
Thank you.
I don't see any sharing and caring. Is this our future? Where there is no life and all humans are being robots?
Our world is a better place.
Let's go back.
My third wish.
Let's go around our world to explore different culture and religion. Let's spread peace, harmony and brotherhood.
Yes, my third wish. Let's spread peace and harmony. Explore our world.
Your wish is my command. Here I present the magical carpet.
No. I wish to stay here more, but we need to go.
Your wish is my command.
Let's go, my friend.
Ali Baba and Qasim were brothers, but they were very different. Qasim had married for money. His wife was a widow who had inherited her husband's fortune. The two of them were quite wealthy and were well respected in the town. Ali Baba had married for love. He and his wife were very poor, but they were happy together. Ali Baba never envied his brother, nor did he ever ask him for money. One day, Ali Baba went out into the forest to collect firewood. He walked for quite a distance until he came to a place he had never seen before. Wood was plentiful here, and he was pleased to think how much firewood he would be able to gather in a short time. But before he had even drawn out his axe, he heard the sound of a large group of men approaching. Afraid that it might perhaps be a band of dangerous thieves, he found a place to hide behind the small rock. Ali Baba could hardly believe what he had just seen. It appeared that the thieves were using the secret cave to store their treasure. He dared not move. Certainly, these thieves would come out the way they had gone in.
Men, I see a caravan in the distance. Let's attack.
Treasure cave. I can't believe this. I'm going to be rich.
सिम सिम खुल जाओ,
खुल जा सिम सिम।
I dare not stay too long. If the thieves return and find me here, I'm a dead man. I'll take what I can and just come back in the time to get more.
Band ho ja sim sim.
Ali Baba went straight home to show his wife what good fortune had befallen them.
Why didn't Ali Baba try to find out whose treasure it was and return it?
Can you imagine what would happen if Ali Baba held up a bag of gold coins in the marketplace and called out, "Do these belong to anyone?"
I guess everyone would try to claim them.
It might have been fatal for Ali Baba. So, Ali Baba came home and showed the bag of coins to his wife.
Zarina! 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 Dear wife, as of today, all our troubles are over.
Ali, have you become a thief? We are not so poor that you need to rob in order to eat. Give these back immediately.
No, 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 my dear. I stole nothing. The band of thieves did the stealing, not I. I simply stumbled across their secret cave.
A band of thieves? Where? Where did you see them?
Yes, the worst sort of thieves you could possibly imagine. I hid myself and watched as their leader recited the magical words that opened the cave.
We must use it wisely and make it last a long time. I don't want you walking into danger again anytime soon.
Yes, you're right. And we can't let anyone know about it. Not even my brother Kasim.
Good idea. But let me count the coins first.
Why? It's easy to estimate that it should last us quite a while.
I want to count them.
All right, as you please. I'll go to the market to buy some small leather pouches. We'll bury them in sets of 50 in our backyard.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is going to take all afternoon. It would be faster just to weigh them with a scale. Oh, but I sold our scale last month in order to buy these cushions. No matter. I'll just go over to Kasim's house and borrow a scale from my sister-in-law. Hello? Hello? Are you home?
Oh, hello, darling sister-in-law. Come in. Please sit and join me for tea.
I just want to borrow your scale, if I may.
My scale? Why? Yes, of course. I'll get it right away. Here you are, Zarina. Happy measuring.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, sister-in-law. I'll give it back soon.
Who was just here?
Your sister-in-law. She came to borrow our scale.
Our scale? What could Ali Baba possibly have that needs to measure using his scale? The dust of his floor or the dead flies of his windowsill?
Ha ha ha. We may be able to discover the truth without even asking any questions. Before I gave the scale to her, I put a fresh piece of wax on the bottom. Perhaps some of what she's measuring will stick to the wax and she won't even notice it.
Dear, that's brilliant.
Thank you, my dear.
Good afternoon, Kasim. I have come to return your scale.
Ah, thank you. We hardly missed it. Did you finish your weighing then?
Yes, thank you for the help. Good day.
Well, shall we have a look?
Oh!
Ah, what is this? Gold coin?
My brother has been measuring gold coins? Impossible! He's as poor as a dervish.
I'm going to pay Alibaba visit right now and find out what's going on. Alibaba! Alibaba! Where are you, Alibaba? Alibaba!
Kasim.
What is the meaning of this messaging business? How dare you act innocent? How have you become so fat? You have so much gold that you are measuring with a scale.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't play games with me, Alibaba.
No.
Tell me the truth.
Don't tell me the truth.
Yes, Kasim, I confess. It is the truth. My wife and I were measuring gold coins, but we only got them just today. That's the honest truth.
Alibaba, I should report you. Report you to the royal guards.
No, Kasim.
Wait, Kasim.
Kasim, I did not steal them. I promise, I did not steal them.
So, Alibaba told Kasim the whole story about the band of thieves and the treasure cave. He told him the location of the cave and the secret password. He told Kasim not to go to the cave alone, as it was far too dangerous. Kasim promised not to go alone, but this was, in fact, exactly what he intended to do. Kasim leaves Alibaba's house and goes to the cave, taking the donkey.
If I were Kasim, I wouldn't go to the cave without Alibaba. One of them could stand outside and watch for the thieves, while the other went inside the cave to collect treasure.
That would have been a very smart plan. Kasim's wife said the very same thing. However, Kasim was not only greedy, he was a bit stupid as well. The next day, he gathered up as many bags as he thought he possibly could carry and headed off to the cave without Alibaba. By noon, he arrived at the treasure cave.
Where's my slip? What is the password?
Kulja! Kulja! Kulja jamun? Kulja jilebi? Kulja papita? Kulja anarkali? Kulja kajur? Kulja pagal patra kulja? Kul!
What's this?
Kulja Simsim?
Can I say Kulja Simsim?
Quit doing my job for me.
Sorry.
Kulja Simsim.
Kulja
Simsim.
Take him into the cave and kill him!
No! No!
We leave his body here as a warning to anyone else who dares to enter our cave. Now let us depart to another venture.
Janak, don't you think we better say, Band ho ja Simsim?
Hey, that's my job. Band ho ja Simsim.
Kasim had been gone a long time and his wife begins to worry. Alibaba promised her that he would go to the cave to find out what had happened to Kasim.
K- कासिम 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 खुल जा सिम सिम ओ कासिम कासिम I told you not to come alone, you silly brother. Well, I must get you back home. I will give you a splendid funeral. But wait a minute, I'll need to pay for the splendid funeral. There, now let's be off. Stop, donkey.
Band ho ja, sim sim.
So, Ali Baba gave Qasim a splendid funeral. He also spent a bit of money on himself and bought new clothes, a larger house, and a servant to help his wife with the housework. The servant's name was Mir Jahan, and she turned out to be the best investment that Ali Baba would ever make.
So that's what happened to poor Qasim. Although, I must say he brought it upon himself. What happened to the band of thieves? They're still out there robbing caravans. They don't know about Ali Baba. They think Qasim was the only person to discover their cave. But surely, they saw that the body of Qasim was gone from the cave. They probably figured that a wild animal dragged it off. Wild animals can't say Kulja Simsim.
Shh.
But perhaps there is another way into the cave. Ali Baba mentioned some kind of crack in the ceiling of the cave that let in some light. Would Ali Baba be able to recognize any of the thieves if they came into the town disguised as merchants?
I don't think I could.
So how would we know if they were here?
We'll just keep our eyes and ears open. That's the best we can do.
Meanwhile, the thieves discovered that Qasim's body was missing from the cave, as well as some gold bags. They figured out that someone other than Qasim had discovered how to enter their cave. A small group of merchants carrying various items that they might be buying or selling in the market. The leader, Hassan, decided to disguise himself and go into the town to ask the villagers if they knew anyone who had suddenly become wealthy in recent months.
Excuse me. Excuse me, sir. I know this is a strange question, but do you have any neighbors who have suddenly become quite wealthy in recent times? For reasons I can't go into, I believe that such a person is a relative of mine. I need to contact him with important information about the inheritance.
It could be Ali Baba. He has been poor as a dervish, but recently he purchased a new house and also hired a servant.
Yes, he lives right there.
Can you direct me to his house?
Yes, sir. He lives right there.
Thank you very much, sir.
Welcome, welcome.
Ali Baba, have I come to the right place? I recognize that souvenir. That's mine. Ali Baba, I'll get every last treasure back from you. But I must think of a plan to get my men in here without making anyone suspicious. Ali Baba? Ali Baba.
Yes?
Is your master home?
No, but my mistress is. He trusts her in everything. Sir, would you like to speak to her?
Yes, thank you.
Please have a seat.
Madam, I'm an oil merchant. I have come to your town today to offer you and your neighbors a once-in-a-decade deal on oil jars. I have a sale at only 2 dinars for an oil jar.
2 dinars? For a big oil jar? That's marvelous. How many jars can I buy?
I can offer you 40 oil jars.
Well, I'll take all of them.
I will return tomorrow to deliver the jars and collect my payment.
We will be expecting you.
Thank you for your business. Until then. Ali Baba, face my wrath.
Hassan hurried back to his band of thieves and they made their preparation. He told his thieves to sneak into the town in the middle of the night and go to Ali Baba's house. Each thief would hide in an oil jar. When Hassan came to collect payment from Ali Baba's house the next morning, he would give the signal and they would all jump out, kill everyone in Ali Baba's household and haul away the treasure in their sacks. Line up in front of Ali Baba's house. Now, it happened that Mir Jahan woke up very early that morning, before the sun came up.
I think I'll get an early start on my work today. Maybe I can finish early and have some free time this evening. Maybe I should sweep along the side of the house and clear a space for those oil jars that will be arriving this morning.
Mir Jahan was very surprised to see that the oil jars had apparently been delivered in the middle of the night. This seemed a bit suspicious to her and she decided to investigate. Mir Jahan kneels down and examines the jars. She pokes the first one. The thief speaks.
Hassan, is that you? Is it time?
Not yet.
Hassan? Is that you? Is it time?
No, not yet.
Shall we come out?
No, not yet.
Mir Jahan knew that she would have to find a way to get rid of the thieves without making any noise. If one of the thieves jumped up and sounded the alarm, Ali Baba's household was doomed. Just 3 days ago, Mir Jahan had discovered rats destroying their garden and she had purchased a remedy from the apothecary.
I hope this works quickly and quietly. Just what I need. A hot oil with the rat poison. All right, human rats.
Say that every cloud has a silver lining. Good and bad are sometimes like the two sides of a coin. Then Hassan arrived at the crack of dawn. He goes over the oil jars.
Men, the time has come. Men, up and ready. This is the signal. Attack! What? How can this be? Who has done this? Ali Baba, you'll pay dearly for this. I'll avenge the deaths of every one of my comrades before the sun sets today.
What happened to the thieves?
Mir Jahan cleverly told the merchants to stay out of the jars as they were full of rats and other vermin. Of course, no one wanted to open the jars to see the dead rats. They just took the jars and threw them into a pit and covered it over. And that was the end of the 40 thieves. Ali Baba and his wife had no idea how narrowly they had escaped death.
What about Hasan? Did he come back?
Of course he did. He had to get his revenge.
That oil merchant you were telling me about, when did he say he would arrive?
Think of the devil, and the devil is here.
Ali Baba.
Yes, I'm sorry I missed you yesterday. Please come in.
Master, would care for some entertainment while you eat? I could dance for you.
We could dance for you.
Yes, that would be fine. We'll entertain our guest.
حبيبي يا نور العين يا ساكن خيالي عاشق بقالي سنين ولا غيرك في بالي حبيبي يا نور العين يا ساكن خيالي عاشق بقالي سنين ولا غيرك في بالي حبيبي يا نور العين يا ساكن خيالي عاشق بقالي سنين ولا غيرك في بالي حبيبي يا نور العين يا ساكن خيالي عاشق بقالي سنين ولا غيرك في بالي
other than the leader of the band of thieves.
Oh, Mirjahan, how can I ever repay you for saving our lives? I must give you your freedom immediately.
Splendid idea.
And so, the humble servant girl, Mirjahan, saved her master's household and became a part of their family.
And then what?
They lived happily ever after. Of course, they kept the secret of the cave and no one else ever found about it. And if the king permits me, I will tell an even better story tomorrow night.
The king permits on one condition. It must be funny.
Then funny it shall be.
Shall we walk Dinarzade to her quarters?
Yes, we shall. Let us dance for Ali Baba.
Thank you.
For giving us this spectacular show. Another huge round of applause to the entire cast.
There's a lot that we have learned from them too. The Thousand and One Night represents the rebel in a queen who's strong, creative, imaginative, and a clever idol who inspires all of us.
It teaches us the values of being humane and living in peace and harmony.
May we now request our young, talented, and dynamic chief guest, Mr. Nag Ashwin, to address the gathering. We request our vice principal, Mrs. Kiran Panjwani, to escort the chief guest to the dais.
Hello. Good evening, everyone. And wow, we just saw something so huge and amazing that I just come immediately after that. I'm still overwhelmed with what I saw, and 500 people, 500 kids on stage. First of all, Dr. Narasimhareddy, sir, thank you for calling me, distinguished guests. It's a pleasure to be here with you today. I am from HPS Begumpet, 2002 batch, and I was Red's Nagarjuna, so a shout out to all my Nagarjuna brothers and sisters. Hi. And what else, man? I was just speaking to sir, and sir was saying this whole thing is pre-recorded, this 1.5 hours. Hi, all the kids are behind, but yeah. 1.5 hours of these guys having to hit their cue, like their mark, their dialogue, and about 1 hour into this, I was seeing that each of their lip sync for their dialogues was perfect, and that's great. Like, you know, for our when we make films, like we have so many takes, we shoot the same thing in so many different angles, and we edit it, and it takes about a year or something to make a film. And these kids have done a great job. Like, it's amazing to be here and watch all of this today. Definitely a privilege. And I studied for 12 years in HPS Begumpet, from 1st to 12th. I did MBIPC in my 11th and 12th. So you see, it has absolutely nothing to do with what I'm doing right now. And my parents were doctors, my grandparents are doctors, my mother's sister is a doctor, her husband is a doctor, so there are like so many doctors in our family that it seemed obvious that I would probably become a doctor, but I didn't, I became a director. So it's still kind of possible to write DR in front of my name, kind of. But it's actually at HPS where, you know, I got the chance to explore like what I really like and what I want to do, because HPS gives you that space. Like, it's not so stifling, even now, even back then, it's not so stifling in terms of like, you know, trying to rub you into one sort of groove. It gives you space, and I think one of the earliest things that gave me confidence was, if you guys have English 1 and 2, in one of the papers you have a composition where there's an option where you can write where they just give you one line, you know, there's that line goes like, you know, and then he suddenly heard a sound and he turned around, dot, 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 finished the composition. So that sort of a composition. So I realized I enjoyed writing fiction, and I enjoyed writing, and then I ended up becoming the editor of our school magazine. I ran a small newsletter. I started one basketball league in HPS. It gives you space to do so many things. So I started writing, and then through writing I joined advertising, and through advertising I made a film. And the first film was shot in Mount Everest. It was shot near the Mount Everest base camp. And for a Telugu film, like, you know, nobody expected, that a film that was shot in Mount Everest and it's about a coming of age self-discovery thing would do well. But it did well, and I got to do my second film, and the second film was a biopic, sort of a tragedy about one of the greatest actresses that we have, Savitri Garu, and that again, there was no reason why that movie should do well. There was never an example of a biopic in Telugu or South Indian cinema. But just purely on the number of tickets sold, Mahanati is the second biggest film in the US, at least after Bahubali. So, and you know, that's, I'm very proud to say that because I am from HPS, I'm an eagle like all of you, and this is our success, I guess. And what I saw today was no less than a Bahubali of school plays, and it's amazing. And like, you know, I think over the years, like there's a standard that, you know, HPS, Begumpet or Ramanthapur, eagles are eagles anywhere. You know, we just see that there's really, you know, with all the new schools, everything coming up, you have so much the advertising for these new private schools and this and that, international, this, that. But HPS is HPS, man. You guys are so lucky to be here. And there is nobody else. There is no place else like this. Once you go, it's been 16 years since I left HPS. But, you know, HPS hasn't left me, I think. I think that's even more obvious when I'm standing here today. And yeah, once you guys leave, if you anywhere, any part of the world, I lived in like 10 cities across the world in different places. And every time you meet somebody from HPS or some memory comes back, it's very special. And, you know, people like, you know, I've luckily made films, then you obviously have even more popular alumni who have done like so many things. They've become chief ministers, they've become CEOs, they run like half of the biggest companies in the world. So you don't have, you can do whatever you want, become scientists, doctors, engineers, directors if you want, actors, cameramen, whatever, man. Like, but you know, you are at the greatest place where you can start off to be the best version of yourself. And thank you for having me here. Another big round of applause to these kids today. An amazing job. Thank you for having me. Good night. Sorry, I need
so
to be here.
So we request you to hold on for a moment while our principal, Dr. Narasimha Reddy, joins you on the stage to present a memento.
May we now request our principal to come onto the dais and present a memento to our eminent chief guest, sir.
It's a much-needed appreciation and encouragement that we all required. Thank you, sir. It is truly an honor to have met someone of your stature and influence. Your achievement in the field of your passion is commendable and noteworthy.
We are indeed thankful to our principal to give all of us this special opportunity to meet you today. Thank you, sir.
Once again, we thank our chief guest, Mr. Nag Ashwin, for spending his valuable time with us this evening. We also take the pleasure.
Sure. Hi. So I've got this amazing trophy, and I hope in the future, 16 years later, a lot of you get a chance to hold this. It's a really cool feeling. And I think some really good news for all of you guys. Tomorrow's a holiday. Well, it's Sunday. Day after is also a holiday. So have a good time, guys.
Thank you, sir, for that holiday. Once again, we thank our chief guest, Mr. Nag Ashwin, for spending his valuable time with us this evening. We also take the pleasure to thank the dignitaries, members of the Hyderabad Public School Society, Board of Governors, and guests for their presence. We deem it a great support and encouragement.
We also thank all the parents for their immense support and cooperation. I congratulate all the participants for their captivating and zealous performance. You are the stars of this evening. Kudos to your hard work and effort. A very special mention of Mr. Deepak Keshwa and his team for helping us put up such an amazing show. A big round of applause to your audience.
We have dreams of the past, you must fight just to keep them alive. king, eye of the tiger, it's the thrill of the fight, rising up to the challenge of our rivals. And the last known survivor stalks his prey in the night, and he's watching his all in the eye of the tiger. Face to face, out in the heat, for a kill with the skill to survive. It's the eye of the tiger, it's the thrill of the fight, rising up to the challenge of our rivals. And the last known survivor stalks his prey in the night, and he's watching his all in the eye of the tiger. Rising up straight to the top, had the dirt got the glory.
Request all the high school students and the ex-students to join us on the stage while we sing song. All the students.
Countdown.
call to everyone. Please join us.
Heavy, feels like the winds are gonna change beneath my feet. The earth is ready. I know it's time for heaven's rain. It's gonna rain. Living waters we desire to flood our hearts with holy fire.
Rain down all around the world, we're singing. Rain down, my heart is dry but still I'm singing. Rain down, can you hear the earth is singing? Rain.
Heart is heavy, feels like it's time to dream again. I see the clouds, and yes, I'm ready to dance upon this barren land. Hope in my hand. Living waters we desire, flood our hearts with holy fire.
Rain down, all around the world we're singing. Rain down, can you hear the earth is singing? Rain down, my heart is dry but still I'm singing.
Yes? Do you want one more song? Yes. Seems like everybody's got a price. I wonder how they sleep at night. When the sale comes first and the truth comes second, just stop for a minute and smile. Why is everybody so serious? Acting so damn mysterious. You got shades on your eyes and your heels so high that you can't even have a good time. Everybody look to the left.
To the left.
Everybody look to the right.
To the right.
Can you feel that? Yeah. We'll pay with love tonight. It's not about the money, money, money. We don't need the money, money, money. We just wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Ain't about the
cha-ching, cha-ching.
Ain't about the
ba-bling, ba-bling.
Wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. We need to take it back in time when music made us all unite, and it wasn't no blows and video.
Six strings and a half sack, and you can keep the cars, limit the garage, and all I, it's all I need is the keys and guitars, and it's within 30 seconds I'll move to Mars. Yeah, we're living across this indefeatable odds. It's like this, man, you can't put a price on my life. So we do this for the love, so we fight and sacrifice every night. So hey, I stumble and fall,
never
waiting to see. This is the sound of feet. We don't keep everyone moving their feet. Bring back the beat.
It's not about the money, money, money. We don't need the money, money, money. We just want to make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Ain't about the
cha-ching, cha-ching.
Ain't about the
bling, the bling.
Want to make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. It's not about the money, money, money. We don't need your money, money, money. We have now come to the end of this program. May we request all to rise for the national anthem. Your evening was wonderful. Wishing you all a very good night.
Shabak hai.
Jai Hind.